All right, in this video, let's talk about midterm rental leases. So, disclaimer, I am not an attorney. I'm just gonna be showing you exactly what I do for my properties. But again, I'm not an attorney. This is not legal advice. Okay, so first question I get is, Bailey, when should I even do a lease agreement? And again, not my legal advice, but this is what I personally do. If I get reservations from Airbnb or from Vrbo, I personally don't do a lease agreement. I only do a lease agreement when I get reservations outside of Airbnb or Vrbo, which could be any sort of direct bookings, furnish finder, insurance companies, literally anything outside of Airbnb and Vrbo, I will do a lease agreement for. So that's the first thing. Second thing is, Bailey, where do you get an actual lease from? So I use a site called TurboTenant, and I'll give you a full demo here at the end of TurboTenant. So I'll show you exactly how it works. You can also use a site called Keycheck, which is Furnish Finder's sister company. So they have leases you can use. Or of course, you can have an attorney draft you up a template that you can use moving forward. One important thing to note is that leases do vary state to state. So some states have specific laws, which is why you either want to use an attorney or you want to make sure a website that you do use has specific things in place that your state does require. And I know from my experience, TurboTenant and Keycheck both comply with that. Third thing is what software to use to sign. So I use a software called GoHighLevel. I'll leave a link down below to a full tutorial of kind of what I use GoHighLevel for, totally optional, but there it is down there. You could also use Keycheck. You could use a site called Panadocs, DocuSign, or you could literally just look up any other document signing software. These are just the ones that I personally have experience with. All right, so now let's go through a walkthrough of exactly how I prepare my leases. So first things first, like I mentioned, I use a software called TurboTenant. Now I will say there is a cost to it. And if you use my link down below, we'll both get some type of reward when you sign up for it. And yes, I am an affiliate, but this is exactly who I do use for my leases. So I'm just telling you this transparently. So they have a free version and they also have a paid version, but you will want to get the paid version to get all of the exact leases and documents that you're going to need. So you can go ahead and press on landlord sign up or click the link down below. It'll take you to the right page. I'm going to go ahead and just log in. So the first thing that you're going to want to do is you're going to want to go to properties, and then you're going to want to click on add new property, and then go ahead and input the information for your property. So I'll just give like an example one here, single family home, not renting by the room. And we'll just make up an address, 123 Main Street, Milwaukee, Wisconsin. All right, and then we're gonna press next. So we're gonna say it's a 3-bed, 2-bath house and our target rent is $3,000 a month. Deposit, again, this doesn't really matter. This is really talking about a security deposit. So I'm just gonna put 0 for now. I'm gonna press on I'm done. Okay, now what we're gonna do is we're gonna press skip for now and we're gonna go over to forms. So what you're gonna see here is they have, again, with the upgraded version, a ton of different forms. So these are the state specific lease agreements. We're gonna get to that in a second. Lease agreement addendums. So this is if you're gonna like change the terms of the lease. Maybe the guest wants to move out early, or again, any reason why you need to change the lease agreement, you can do that with this form here. And they have a bunch of other forms too you can check out. But really the main one I use is the state specific lease agreement. So I'm gonna press on start lease and I'm gonna go to lease and I'm gonna click on add new lease. Okay, and then I'm gonna click on property and I'm gonna click on this 123 Main Street and we're gonna call this demo. Okay, so this is just the nickname, obviously, this is the demo. So start date, let's just say that someone's gonna move in April 18th, right? Because a lot of times from my experience, it's rarely the first of the month. And let's just say they're going to stay for a couple months and check out on the 12th, let's just say. And then it's going to ask us when the lease ends on the date above, which of these should occur? So I'm going to, you can pick whichever one you want, just to kind of walk you through the options here. The go month to month automatically. This is really common for insurance companies who they'll put a family in your property for, let's just say, 3 months to start. And then they want it to go month to month. So that's typically the option I pick for them. Or let's just say it's a traveling nurse and they're like, hey, listen, my contract's literally only these dates. I'm not extending. Then I'd pick let the lease terminate on the date above. So those are the two options. And then go ahead and press on add lease. All right, from here, we're gonna click on start next to lease specifics. So we have the address that automatically populated in there. We're gonna press on save and next because we already did this information. All right, now the monthly rent. So this defaulted to 3,000 since that's what we put in originally, but you can of course change it. Let's just say our new price is actually 4,000. So we'll change that there. Will you charge pet rent? So this is gonna be a monthly rent. If you're just doing a one-time pet fee, you'll press no. If you are gonna truly charge a monthly fee for the pet, then you'll press yes. And you'll put in the monthly rate here. Let's just say $50 a month, whatever it is. Personally, I don't charge a pet rent. I'll show you what I I do in a little bit here, but I say no to pet rent. Prorated rent. So if your tenant is not moving in on the first of the month, you may want to charge a prorated amount. This covers their rent until their first full rent payment is due. So oftentimes I click yes here, and then I press on use our prorated rent calculator. So I mentioned, let's go down here, that the rent per month is now $4,000. And let's just say April, I think it was 18th that I said that they're gonna move in. Okay, so it shows that the first month's prorated rent is $1,733.33. Because they're not going to be there for the full month. They're only going to be there for a little bit less than half the month. So what I like to do is take this number and put it right here for the prorated rent amount, meaning their first payment is going to be just for that first portion. Okay. Deposits. If you do a security deposit, you can put that here or any other type of deposit there. And then do you require a pet deposit? Put yes or no. I'm going to still put no here. And here's where it's cool because it'll show you specific laws for your state. So you can press on read more to see every state's a little bit different. So again, just take a look at that. And then here we go, one-time fee. So I press yes here. This is where I'll put in my cleaning fee. So again, I'm just making up numbers here. Pet fee, this again, so one-time pet fee. So you can put that there and you can add as many additional fees as you'd like there. Okay, cool. Then payment accepted. So how will you collect rent? I personally click on this other method outside of TurboTenant and I click on other payment services and then I just type in debit or credit card, small processing fee or ACH, which is free, but no processing. And again, I use Baselane for my payment collection. I have a whole different video on that you guys can check out, but feel free to click whichever one is applicable to you. And then we'll press on save and next. All right, here's where you're gonna add your tenant's name. So you'll press on enter new tenant, and you're gonna put in their first name, last name, and then you'll put in their email here, and then we'll press on enter new tenant. Okay, you can see me pop up there. Will there be any additional occupants? Additional occupants live at the property but are not responsible for the lease and therefore do not sign. It's usually children or other dependents. So if yes, you could put yes. If no, you could put no. Normally, if it's a kid, I won't ask for their full name. So that's just a personal thing. I guess you can. But if it's a child, I don't ask for that stuff. I want to know how many people are staying there, but I don't necessarily need to know their name. So in this case, I would just put if it's a son or daughter, put that there, and then I'd do the age of 0. If you know their age, great, but it's not something I like to like really pry into. And then scrolling down to landlord, so enter type. So again, for me personally, I do it under the company, my LLC. You can do this under your individual if you'd like, but again, my preference is doing it under my company. So you can put your LLC information here, aka your company name, and then your mailing address. So an address must be listed in case your tenants need to mail you notice. So again, this is your mailing address, not the property address. So make sure you have both of those filled out. And then down here, will the tenants have a mailing address that differs from the rental property address, such as a PO box? No. Will there be co-signers? Again, up to you, but in this case, no. All right, and again, it's just guiding us through. So will there be pets on the lease? We're gonna put yes. We're gonna say it's a dog, it's a golden retriever, let's just say, 50 pounds, and it's 5 years old. Okay, you can add another pet if you need. Smoking, do you allow smoking at this property? You can either put yes, no, or outside only. I'm gonna put no. Do you want to include parking rules? So if you click yes, this will pop down, and you can click on these different things. And then you can also, you know, you can read this, but you can edit the information that's here. This is just some pre-written verbiage that I'd say most of you guys would agree with, but of course you can go ahead and edit, delete, change right on here, okay? Or you can also press no, you don't want to include parking rules, up to you. Okay, let's keep going down. Renter's insurance. So do you require renter's insurance? This is totally optional. I typically don't require renter's insurance. Again, I'm not saying that's a right thing or the wrong thing to do. I just don't require it. So you can put no, but yes here. Totally up to you. But again, I put no. So go ahead, save and next. All right, indicate who's responsible for the following. So at my properties, I'm responsible for the electricity, the internet, okay? Phone, I don't have a phone, so I'll put NA. Cable / satellite, I don't have that, so I just put NA. Gas, water, these are all things that I pay for. And then lawn care, snow removal, and then again, condo fees, I don't have that, so NA. Personally, again, how I do my rentals is I pay for everything. No utilities or anything is charged to the tenant. So if yours is different, then you can, of course, click the tenant. Are there any shared utilities for this property? Again, this is gonna be state by state. This is something that Wisconsin asks for, but my properties in Indiana don't. So I'm gonna put no in this case. Which keys will your tenants receive? So garage door opener, mailbox, property, how many copies are they gonna get? Put that there and then press on save and next. Additional terms, so any other additional things you wanna add, you could do that here. Was this property built prior to January 1st, 1978? Again, put no or yes. If you put yes, it's going to ask you for a couple more questions about the lead paint and other things. Again, you can just read this. Do you have any past code violations? I'm going to press on no. And then again, this is state by state. So this says Wisconsin law requires that a condition report be filled out and attached to the lease agreement. So make sure, again, you are staying compliant and reading everything that's state specific. All right, so we completed the lease specifics, the rent deposit and fees, the people on the lease, pets, smoking, and others, utilities, and the provisions and attachments. So next, what we're going to do is we're going to press on review and e-sign. And then here is where we can read through. And you'll be able to see this is the lease. It's just watermarked, but this is just a preview of it. So you can, again, read through it, make sure everything looks good. And if it does, you can press on finalize and e-sign. Okay, so then from here, you have two options. You can either set up for e-signatures or you press skip for now. I personally press skip for now. And then ready to charge your tenants, I press maybe later. So what I do from here personally is I click on the lease agreement right there. And then I go look up PDF to Word. Okay, you can click on whatever one pops up first. This one's great. And then what I do is I drag and drop the lease agreement in here. And then I go to convert. And then I press on download. And then I open it up. Okay, and then from here, I just like to read through it, make sure everything looks good. That's why I do it this way, and I convert it to a Word document. Because if I want to edit this at all, it's a lot easier to just do it from a Word document, in my opinion. So again, you can just read through it, make sure it all looks good. So that's just how I do it. And then what I do from here personally is then I'll upload this to get the signatures. Now, before I show you that though, let me go back to the lease agreement. What you could do instead is you could just say, Bailey, I'm not that high maintenance. I just want to press on request e-signatures and get the signing done through TurboTenant, which is totally fine if you want to do that. You can title the document here, press on next, and then you can do set signatures or put a little message in here. So attached is the lease agreement. Okay, and this is gonna be sent out to the tenant and you as the landlord. So if we scroll down, if you keep scrolling down, you're gonna see, let's see what page, I think it's 14, but let's just see. Okay, cool. So on page 15, it has already set the signatures for you, which is really nice. It already has everything set, so you don't have to do it. Same thing with the initials down here. Again, everything's already set, so it makes it really easy. In this case, all you have to do is press on send for signatures if you're going to use TurboTenant's signature platform, which again, it is very easy. And then again, you can read the instructions here, but it's going to essentially send a copy for the tenant to sign, and then you can also sign it. And then if you want to do rent collection, again, I'm going to do maybe later. Okay, so this is the email that the tenant will receive. So they're going to press on review and sign. Okay, they're going to press on sign the document. And again, this is the screen that the tenant will see. So get started. They're going to sign, insert everywhere. Next. Okay, they're going to put their initials there. Continue. And then I agree. And then it'll take the guest to this screen to set up basically their portal through TurboTenant. They don't really need to do this, but they can if they'd like. And then what is going to happen on your end, if I refresh the page, you're going to see that it says signed from the tenant. And then you can sign here. So you press on sign document. And then you can go through the exact same process. Get started. Click here to sign. Okay, insert everywhere. Okay. And then if we refresh the screen and you go ahead and click on lease agreement here. So then on this screen, you'll see it's pending. So usually it takes couple minutes for it to load, and then you can click on this lease agreement and you'll see the signed version of it. So that's one way to do it. Again, I mentioned that I use a different software. It takes a little bit more steps, and honestly, TurboTenant is very easy. So I don't really have a great reason that I use another software other than the fact that sometimes I like to edit the lease. But for the most part, it's pretty good. So that's the process that I go through. And again, you can use Keycheck, PandaDocs, DocuSign. I just showed you how to do it on TurboTenant. Or again, you can use High Level to get the leases signed. So I hope you guys got value out of that video, and I will see you guys in the next one. Peace.